a stone plinth. The pieces of mosaic that Angelina wrote about fit in the three grooves on each side of it. Nothing. No mosaic tiles. I think I know who's got it. Blackmere Castle. It'd be best if I walk and steer clear of the village and the roads. Would one day lead here. I'll find out who my father is, find the mosaic pieces, and make sure that Angelina's death hasn't been in vain. But I gotta be damn careful. According to Angelina, at least one of the castle's residents is a member of the Order. Maybe I can find out who that is. Electric doorbell? I was expecting an old bell. Nothing. Maybe it's broken. The braces on this door are badly weathered. Two have turned to rust and not even connected to the doorframe at the bottom. No way. The braces are only connected to the frame on one side, but they're much more resistant than I thought. There's a really thick branch lying in the undergrowth. Looks solid. It's damp, but not rotten. It must have broken off the tree quite recently. Maybe in the storm yesterday. Using this branch as a lever should work. That's it.
How did you get in here?
The gate was open.
Really? I'll wring that brat's neck. I've told her 100 times that the gate must always stay closed if we don't want yobos snooping around the grounds.
If you're referring to me, I'm not a yobo. I'm a policeman.
Oh, you don't say. Then you're sure to have ID. Can I help you, sir?
I've told Mr.
Lewis, good sir. To you, it's just Lewis. You'll take care of this bit. Wonderful. You will have to excuse our gardener, sir. How can I help you?
My name is Falk. I'm investigating a murder that occurred at the lighthouse last night.
I heard about that. Tell me, your accent.
I'm part of an exchange program. The United States, Canada, and Great Britain exchange detectives to learn about the various investigative methods. Sherlock Holmes meets Dick Tracy, you might say.
If the government deems it necessary. What about Inspector Collier? Shouldn't he be accompanying you?
He's sick today.
I see. He is getting on a bit. How can I help you?
Phew. This is an amazing property.
Indeed. It's a place steeped in history.
Unfortunately, all that history often had plenty to do with blood, death, and misfortune, from what I've heard.
The Gordon family was often put to the test. That's true.
Forgive me for putting it like this, but the castle doesn't make the best impression.
I don't understand what that has to do with your inquiry, Mr. Falk.
A witness saw an unusual black car at the crime scene.
What do you mean by unusual? The Gordon family does have a classic 30s English automobile in its possession.
Unusual enough. Were you up on the cliff with the car this morning?
The ladies haven't driven out anywhere today. And I also don't think that Lewis has taken the car either. Ask him. He looks after the car. Mainly when he should be looking after the garden.
This Lewis has a bit of an abrupt manner.
He's... Welsh. He came with his mistress, Lady Eleanor, when she moved in here after the death of her husband. He used to look after her castle's gardens in Wales. He used to have a different kind of work ethic there.
Lady Eleanor owns a castle in Wales?
She does. Her husband, Sir Richard, was killed in a dreadful accident a few years back. She moved here soon after that.
Interesting. You said ladies.
Lady Victoria, she owns Black Mirror Castle, and Lady Eleanor is a relative of hers from Wales. The ladies are the last of the Gordons. They reside here in the castle.
Can I have a word with them?
I would prefer it if you didn't disturb them. Lady Victoria is not a young woman.
No harm in a few words, surely.
Whatever there might be to discuss, you can also discuss with me. I've been involved with the Gordons for more than 70 years. I can tell you everything you may wish to know.
This woman has been murdered. Did you know her?
Are you sure, sir?
Sadly, yes. Her name is Angelina Morgan. You seem to recognize her.
I... Come with me, sir. We'll have to show this to the ladies.
Fine.
One moment, please, sir. I'll announce your arrival.
What was that in the mirror?
Mr. Falk, their ladyships are ready to receive you.
Mr. Falk, is everything all right?
Yes, thank you. I didn't sleep well. Lady Victoria? Lady Eleanor? My name is Inspector Falk. I'm investigating a murder case.
Bates said you had a photograph of the victim.
That's right. Do you know her?
What's her name?
Angelina Morgan.
I don't know her.
If that's everything.
I do have a few more questions.
It's all right, Bates. Of course, we will be glad to cooperate with the police. Drive to the village and do the job I asked you to do. I'm sure the inspector will keep us company.
Very well, ma'am.
So, how can we help you?
You seem to be extremely keen to see the picture of the dead woman. And Bates had a noticeable reaction when I showed him the picture. You are sure that you don't know this young lady?
Quite sure. Only we are concerned. The murder took place quite close to here.
Not the first.
Sadly, you're quite right. It's now. It's 12 years ago, you understand? So many years. And now there's another murder.
Tell me about the series of murders 12 years ago.
No. It doesn't have a thing to do with this crime.
Leave all that alone. Please confine yourself to this murder case. This is quite bad enough already.
Your butler, Bates, seems to be looking after you.
He has been our butler for decades. He is something like the decent soul of this house. He sees it as his highest duty to do all he can for my well-being. Also, even if he neglects his own welfare.
Is he ill?
Yes, I fear he is. We've often suggested that he sit with us and enjoy some peace and quiet for a while. But he always strictly denies that he can no longer fulfill his obligations. We've recently taken on domestic help to at least help him out a little.
May I look around the castle? I'd very much like to talk to Lewis one more time.
Of course. We have nothing to hide. Stay as long as you like. Only please keep away from the private rooms.
That goes without saying, ma'am.